Dreams do come true. It's a question of whether you want to sleep through them or live them. Hello, namaste, and welcome to my channel Pearls in the Ocean. My endeavor is to bring forth people who I have known personally, who have dared to dream, break stereotypes, cut through the cliche, and are doing something that gives them a sense of personal satisfaction. They are making a difference in their own unique way. I hope these conversations resonate with you and inspire you to go the extra mile, just like these pearls in the ocean. Hi everyone, welcome back to Pearls in the Ocean. Today I'm talking to someone who has a blend of his passion with a social cause, a challenge from his own personal life. So we know stories of people pursuing their passions, we know of people who work for a social cause. Mahesh is someone who had a challenge in his own life. I would say his son was identified as autistic at a very early age, and the way Mahesh has taken this in a positive stride and what he's doing today for that cause, as well as blending his passion for music, is something very inspiring. So I want to bring that story out today, and I'm hoping to inspire most of you who are going to view this, that there are problems in life for everyone. We all go through a lot of problems. A lot of things are in our control. Some of them are not in our control. How we perceive it, how positive we are, what kind of a change we can make is all up to us. And if you have something that you're good at, like how Mahesh is with music, then blending that with the other causes is a win-win situation, right? So let's get talking to Mahesh Lad, and we'll hear more about the story from him. Hi Mahesh, welcome to Pearls in the Ocean.
Hello Ranjit, welcome. Good evening to you.
Thank you. Before I start, I want to actually congratulate you for your show last week. And I was there live, and it was a wonderful show. As usual, you and your band did an amazing job, and I want to compliment all of them for that. So I thought I'd put in that word before we start.
Sure thing. Yes, thank you. Actually, thank you. I'm so glad that you were able to join in. And this has been one of our global reaches so far, and especially a lot of my friends and families back in India were able to watch me performing and encourage me. So I was very happy that you were able to join too and support our cause as well as our music.
Absolutely, the pleasure is mine. And like you said, the cause behind it is amazing, which we will talk through this.
Mm-hmm.
So for the purpose of everyone listening, let's go back a little in your journey. And let's see where you started from, Mahesh. Can you tell us something about your childhood, your aspirations that time, and how you grew up, where you grew up, something like that?
Sure. So I am originally from Mumbai, born and brought up in Mumbai. Other than the 4 years I was in Kolhapur for engineering, but all along, like, you know, I'm a Mumbai, Mumbai ka chokra, you can say that. After that, after working, my engineering was in IT, like most of all of us are. So did an IT engineering, computer science and engineering from Kolhapur. Then I came back to Mumbai, worked for 7-8 years. And since then, I came to the US in 1998. And I'm there in New Jersey, actually. So close to New York. So I can call myself New Yorker or New Jerseyan based on who asks. But yeah, I'm proud New Yorker, especially, like, you know, given that it's a happening city and so much resemblance back in the way we live in Mumbai. So I have fun hanging out in New York whenever I get a chance. Yep.
That's about you. You are the engineer come IT professional settled in the US, right?
Yes, absolutely.
Give us a gist of what were your aspirations when you were growing up? What did you want to be? Is this what you actually envisioned, or how did it change? What happened?
I will be very honest, actually. I don't think I had that vision that, you know, I should be engineer or doctor or anything of that sort. I think as I progressed in my education, I got good gurus, actually. I believe in guru a lot. Spiritually also, I believe in having gurus. And my gurus who came in different names and forms, they continue to guide me to take the next step. So I'll tell you, like when I was in 10th standard, when I passed out my SSC, I got a guru. His name is Professor Desai. So his, I went to him. He taught me physics. He developed interest for me for engineering. And I got like very good marks in PCM, just all credited to that guru. And then after that, I went to engineering. So all that actually started, like, you know, I started getting those directions as and when I pursued those steps. So I don't think further, like, you know, 10 years, 15 years. Okay, now this is what the path is. Let's take that. My guru is always there, who's going to, guiding me to move forward and all. So that's exactly how my career happened so far. Even to US and all that, it was never planned. I never thought, and I have to do engineering. Okay, after engineering, I need to do a job. After job, all these kind of directions started coming, and I really am thankful to having the gurus who guided me all along.
Very nice. I like the fact that you acknowledge the people who helped you through your journeys, right? That's a nice thing. One other thing I noticed is you went with the flow. You did not plan too much. You had the right guidance. You had the right people to help you, and you're here today. Yeah. Because of that. I like the modesty. I know a little about what you do. So, having said that, I also want to touch a little upon music. I know now you're classically trained, but again, if I go back, say to your childhood or something, how can you talk about your interest and how did it develop? Is it a family thing? How did music start in your blood?
Sure. Then I realized that, you know, I didn't talk about anything about music too, but you know, that always being my integral part since my childhood. My dad, who passed away actually last year, but he was an excellent harmonium player. He was a good singer. He had his band on Marathi folk music. My uncle, my dad's name is Vinayak Lad. My uncle, Pradeep Lad, he is a music director, actually. He also passed away this year too. But, you know, he assisted Lakshmikant Paralal for almost 20 plus years. He himself composed a lot of private albums for with Suresh Wadkar ji and Hariharan ji and Asha Bhosle ji as well. So, because of the LP impact, there was so much of influence in the house. So a lot of things just got ingrained into me, because my dad used to play music since the morning. Like, you know, every 6 o'clock, we would start with some musical cassette being played. And it was very interesting that so much of that indirectly got influenced. And the best part is both my dad and my uncle, they were all self-made. They didn't learn formally at all. And they were, like, you know, amazing musicians. And that inspired me too, where I didn't learn at all. It was more inherited from them. And I was able to naturally produce both the melody part of it because of my dad, and the rhythm part of it, the whole beats and everything from my uncle too. And I really feel blessed that to have that coaching around. And again, you know, we did learn, but you know, when you're at home, you're studying and all that, it doesn't give you a lot of chances to perform. But my dad assisted so many of my performances there. We used to do bhajan programs even back in Shirdi as well too. We used to go every year, and my dad would accompany me on by harmonium. My uncle used to accompany me on percussions, and that was a seva all along we used to do. And after that, again, I still continued with not still formally learning because of you know how IT, like, and we are traveling around and also it was very difficult to keep up with it. So, but again, with my whole from the family, I was able to like, you know, perform. I sung a lot of Kishore Kumar songs. Musafir Uyaro was my signature song is when I started, and so on and all. I started exploring is where I thought that, like, I'm coming to a plateau from reaching some more like, you know, challenging songs. And not that Kishore Kumar songs are easy. Like, he's my guru actually. I would say the foundation or the base I would have got was after the classical music. And again, a guru came into my life as well, who's guiding me even till today, of how, like, you know, gave me a solid direction, solid voice foundation that I'm going to explore different singers, like, you know, with his guidance. And also, I'm very happy and pleased and to be a musician and a vocalist.
Very nice. The best part is music was always there with you right through your growing years, people around. So it had to naturally come to you. And I like the way you have passionately maintained that through the years. And rightly so, you're getting the right people to help you and guide you. I think for the ones who are trying to seek, and the opportunity is knocking, and if you're not accepting it, then it's difficult, right? Mm-hmm. So you have a positive mind and you are always on the lookout. That's exactly why I think you tend to get the right people as well in your life. So now let me slightly touch upon this part. Okay, so we all, mm-hmm. when people are in the IT field, you have this time to follow anything else, you know, any other hobbies. I hear a lot of people saying no time to do anything at all, right? We're working day and night, late hour calls. How do you manage to do your riyas, or how do you keep your music part alive, other than the show part? I'm saying, how do you manage to keep that going?
Yeah, get a lot of beating from home if I spend time on riyas and all, but honestly, but again, thing is, like, you know, you have to have that drive to do it, otherwise it's never going to happen. So I just go through that grind, but I make sure, like, you know, when, especially when there are concerts and all coming, I do sign up for concerts so that I can do some practice and all that, and it then comes kind of all comes together to that. And again, I think that being like I'm blessed to be a vocalist, and I know that, like, you know, I'm only trying to challenge myself every time with new singers and all that, so it's fun journey. And that drive is pretty high for me to keep motivated to do this riyas and all. I honestly go a little slow when, like, you know, do not have any shows or concerts and all. But I think this year was probably one of my most busy musical year, because I signed up for a lot of Facebook Lives. We did a live concert. We did a remote. I would say all of our musicians were remote and on a Zoom, or other, like, you know, we individual recording our own music and vocals and all of, we mixed up and we did some inspiring songs. We did unplugged type of a Coke studio type of a songs, couple of in spring as well. So this year I thought I got more busier with music than others, and I tend not to do riyas when I'm not doing a show, which is not right, but still, like, you know, one off days and all, whenever I'm sitting in the car, I'll just do some saaf and keep up with my with my riyas all along. So not an easy one, but as I said, like, my music drive is so high that I make sure that, you know, that happens, and I'm not losing touch.
Very nice. So now I want to touch a little bit of the other side of what you're doing, right? Your social I will let you talk about Akhil Autism Foundation. So I will let you tell people what exactly this is, how it started, and
thereon. Sure, no problem. Thank you. So Akhil Autism Foundation, Akhil is my son's name. He was diagnosed with autism at the age of 18 months in 2001, actually. And since then, we were actually devastated before, like, you know, and we never heard about that term before. And the diagnosis was heartbreaking, and a lot of negative stories available on the net and the network which we connected and all. But we as a family together, especially my wife, she took a lead. And you know how moms are, they would, like, you know, go above and beyond to when it comes to the child. So she actually took a lead on getting all the treatments and all done. Even I educated myself, supported it differently. Like, you know, but all the therapies and all the groundwork, she did it to get the right treatments and therapies for Akhil. And he did a lot of progress. And then we educated, or rather we became so much, I would say, experts and I would say the first people to do all these treatments. And these treatments, we did it, like, mostly out of the box. They were not FDA approved, but we heard from other families and all, which helped their children who had autism. And those are the ones which we tried with our son. And he only progressed with, like, you know, every year with different treatments we did. And it's a big puzzle of treatment. It is just not one or two treatments, like, you know, you can take an Advil or a Crocin and we can degrade it. And it requires a lot of persistence to make it happen, because look, all the success and all were, like, you know, you'll get a little bit of improvements in his speech, you'll get a little bit of improvement on his cognition and all those type of but those wins were very high for us. And after that we actually did a lot of diet. My son, we had, like, gluten-free, casein-free, soy-free, corn-free diet for my son for at least, like, you know, 12-13 years since he got diagnosed. We didn't celebrate his birthday because in a birthday there'll be cake, and cake has wheat, and then he cannot eat it. So almost like 7 or 8 years when there were not too many gluten-free options available, we didn't celebrate his birthday as well too. So it was a tough journey, but, like, you know, for our son it was progressing, like, you know, he did so well. with all the treatments. And then we started guiding other people also, other families also who were reaching out to us. Our weekends were going, getting busy with just sharing the same thing again and again. Oh, you should do this one, this protocol first, diet first, then do the oxygen therapy the next, then methyl B12 shots and all. And it was getting too repetitive. And I said, like, you know, we cannot reach out to a lot of families if we try to do this or repeat the same things for limited parents and all, because we have that many hours. So we decided to form a foundation or a nonprofit organization. So we got 501c3 registered in 2008. And since then, it's almost 12 years since then we started foundation. And whatever treatments we do for our son, those are the ones we make it available for children with autism across the globe. So there are around 1,000 plus families we have influenced and helped out in different ways, therapies, webinars, workshops, trainings for parents and all. But like, you know, my son is the first one who gets that treatment. We see that, like, see this improvement. So, okay, now this could help the other children in the cognitive way, or this could help them in the speech way, communications, all of them. We are able to we were able to be the first, and then just to clarify, like, you know, we just gave our son's name to the foundation, but, like, you know, he's one of the members. The whole point of that, like, you know, he being the inspiring or the guiding star, we wanted his name and then how he can make the difference, so that a lot of other children looking at his progress would get inspired. And we are very proud that we are able to rightfully portray the progress which he made. And it's definitely impacted and influenced, and in a positive way, for the families to come forward and also get their children the right treatments and therapies, what my son got it.
Very inspiring, very positive, and very noble, whatever you're doing. It's not just for your own son. I know it's a challenge for you just having your own son there, but, you know, putting it out there for others as well, having a fundraiser to get this moving, spreading the awareness, helping out, big deal.
Yeah.
Big deal, and
yes,
exactly why, you know, you inspire me as well, right? How do you manage fundraising for this? Is it only through music? What else do you do? What are the other options that you have?
Yeah, so music, obviously, because in 2008, we formally formed our band, Kalamanchi USA also. So that's how the music... music is our... We try to do at least one fundraiser. That's how the one which happened last weekend. But we do walkathons, right? We do Facebook fundraisers as well. We do GoFundMe sometimes, but most of the times they are like Facebook fundraisers. They help out. There are always milestone events or charity events happening. We had the Giving Tuesday recently in after Thanksgiving and all, which happened in the US, and also wherever there are opportunities, we do that. But typically music and walkathon are the big ones, which are, like, you know, which requires a lot of planning. And we have, like, you know, big lot of community people coming together. We have sponsors and just, like, we make it. We try to make it as a mega event for these two, music and walkathon.
So yeah, I think it's something, you know, for you to manage your music, Riyaz, as a passion, foundation, the fundraisers, and your job as well, along with family. So really, hats off again for that. How old is your son now?
He'll be 20 in May.
Okay, very nice, very
yes.
Nice. Best wishes to him also. I want to check with you a couple of other things before I let you go. So you had a wonderful journey here, a challenging one, a positive one, and really turning events to your positive side. I want to know from you if you have anything to tell our viewers. A couple of things. I want to understand, for people who want to pursue music and they have a busy schedule, how do they, any tips for them? Second thing is, having challenges in life, how do you face them and how do you overcome the negative side? How do you overcome things that are not in your control and look at it positively? So anything you want to share with our viewers about through your journey, right? You want to tell us about that?
Sure, sure. First of all, my blood group itself is B positive. So it's running in the blood.
For viewers,
so that's the main...
Huh? You have to change your blood group first to get... Okay, that's a good one.
Yeah, so the thing is, keeping a positive mind frame is not easy. And again, I'm not saying we just sail through. As much as I'm smiling right now, we had our challenging times as well. And because thing is, like, you know, he used to go 10 steps ahead and used to sometimes come like, you know, 7 or 8 steps behind over the really very like scary moments across. But again, I think we were persistent about it. And again, I'll really give my credit to my wife, actually. She really, even now also, I find her like, you know, fighting to get all the treatments, whatever is required, having him disciplined and all, to make sure, like, you know, he's getting the treatments. So, so keeping that in mind as well, like, you know, we have the autism cause and all my friends, I'm really blessed. And that's why I get very emotional when we deliver a show, that I have to kudos to everybody that they have unconditionally stood behind me with the band, and just to like, you know, get the fundraisers in place. And the place which you saw in the last concert, it was one of my friend's basement, and like, you know, there's no cost involved into this. Like, you know, they are so generous to just let's do it, whatever is required for the foundation to raise funds. From music perspective, I personally feel like learning classical is important, and I feel like that's the key component. It's very tempting to start singing the Bollywood music, and again, from personal experience, I feel like what I was singing 10 years before I was learning classical, and what I'm doing now is totally different aspect. In fact, I try to sing the same songs I was singing before 10 years before and now, and I myself see there's a lot of appreciation, realization on the music. I got some tips and tricks. I like, you know, I dived into my guru actually helped me with the classical tips and tricks. I like, you know, he coaches me all along with ragas and all. So that's the grammar part of it. Then there are some vocal lessons and all, which are like online. I saw a lot of good videos are there, which I try to practice. And find time, at least, like, you know, even if you are able to do an hour of riyas, or 30 minutes to an hour for a year, that's good enough to keep you up. It's similar to any workout you would do, right? So if you lose out on the workout and all, you start getting little like, you know, not as active and all. So it's same thing as that, like, same, riyaz is a workout of vocal cords, so you just cannot miss that. And again, I definitely try my best to keep up and all, and most of the time, as I said, like, once I sign up for a show or a concert, I'm very successful that I make sure the riyaz is happening. I'm committed to that. On Fridays, like the show behind, I'm just like, you know, doing 2-3 hours of riyaz to get ready for the show. And so that's how it all transforms into. So it's doable. I know the work schedule is the one actually holds me back. I'll be very honest. I work for Salesforce.com. But the thing is, like, you know, they also have, my company has the whole philanthropy angle. So I said, like, you know, for philanthropy, I have to do music. For good music, I need to, or rather, if I need to sound good, I need to do my riyaz. And like, you know, I have to set an example that this is possible, this can be done beyond our schedule. So even if I'm driving, I'll just turn on my tanpura and start doing the riyaz wherever I could sneak out the time. So again, like, you know, if the drive is there, I think anybody, it's possible to be done. The music can be perceived.
Wonderful. Thanks, Mahesh. I think that helps a lot of people who are looking at. I like the concept of driving and practicing. You know, do your riyaz when you're driving. One, nobody can hear you alone in the car as well. So you don't. Yeah. Thanks, Mahesh. That was good tips. Before we leave, why not one jhalak of your singing? Can you sing a couple of lines for us?
Okay, no problem. Again, I'll sing the same title song, because the whole point of having the title of our last concert, Ye Jeevan Hai, was that only. Like, you know, there are always going to be ups and downs in life, but Ye Jeevan Hai. So I'll just sing hum two lines. Again, today I didn't do my riyaz, but I'll try my best to sound at least decent. But the words itself are good enough to inspire your whole theme. And thank you for having such a unique concept as well. I saw your couple of videos, and I got a gist of it, of how, what you're trying to achieve. And kudos to you as well, to having such a, like, you know, an online channel and reaching out to inspiring people across. And again, I'm not saying myself, but I heard those other two peoples, and other, I'm sure there are more coming in. Well, they are like, you know, friends, or we just are hanging out with them. They are just right across, and everybody does the celebrity part of it, and all, but you know, you're reaching out to these are the ones who can set the example and inspire. So thank you for having this concept. I'll sing those two lines, and we can sort of sign out. So, ये जीवन है इस जीवन का यही है यही है रंग रूप ये जीवन है इस जीवन का यही है यही है रंग रूप थोड़े गम है थोड़ी खुशियाँ थोड़े गम है थोड़ी खुशियाँ यही है रंग रूप ये जीवन है
Of course, Dil Mange More, but you know, I will ask for my farmaish offline and here.
Sure thing.
I want to definitely congratulate you on what you're doing, and best wishes to you, your wife, and your kid, and everybody in this support system that you have. You guys are doing a fantastic job. Looking forward to a lot more entertainment from you, and again, best wishes to all the positivity and the support that you're spreading out in the community for everyone.
No problem. And I just wanted to give information about our foundation website, akhilautismfoundation.org. It's available. We have like Facebook page as well. That's where we put most of the stuff. But we are doing a revamp of our website. So you can find out information out there. Please, help is available. A lot of awareness is available. There's a big hope. Our son himself is an inspiration. So we would like to help out. So reach out to our website and for more information. And for music, you can follow us on YouTube. Kalamanch USA Music is our YouTube channel, as well as on Facebook page. You can like our Facebook page as well. So, but thank you again for having me, Ranjit. Thank you. Appreciate it.
Thank you. We'll put in all these details on the comment section as well, so for people to...
Okay, sure.
We'll do a lot of people reaching out to you as well on this. Thanks
again. Anytime.
And I will talk to you again offline. Bye.
Cool. Thank you. Okay, cool. Thank you. Bye.